That was a good little break we took from Ark, right? Because, yeah, it's been a couple days, you know, I've been napping, you know, and a lot of stuff went on in the meantime. So, yeah, welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved, everyone. Season 4 of Pooping Evolved and Season 4 of Us. And it is going on the center map. So, the other day, the center map actually became an official mod. What? What? So that means all you Xbox goers and all you PC goers are now capable of playing it. But in the meantime, we are continuing our current Let's Play, not Let's Play, but our current season. We're already a couple episodes in. What is it, like season 4? And today, oh, look at that. Look at that huge salmon in there. We could get some, oh, actually, this could be good. If we find any creatures that we might want to tame, that if we kill that thing or manage to, although it appears that it might be a couple in the water, we might have to be a little bit cautious. And oh my god, I'm still yawning from that amazing sleep. Oh god. Anyways, those can drop raw prime fish meat for us, which will be fan-frickin-tastic. But, we return. I thought I saw a dodo! Guess what? In the latest update, there's a cool thing that came out. Oh, a level 120 dodo? Oh. You know, I actually really want to tame this now, because it's... It might take a while, but dodo, you will be mine. I hope you... There isn't a lot of topor associated with you. I'm gonna see if I can knock it out. If I kill it, then so be it. I did want to show off a new feature with dodos, if possible. That came from today's update. If not, there might actually be a lower level dodo somewhere over there. Can I just punch this thing, maybe? I feel like this is, there we go. Okay, we're able to knock it out. If I feed it berries, how long? I think I had 240 topor. God, that's actually a very decent amount for what it is. Let's give it some Azul berries. How quickly will it take? We might be able to finish this tame up very quickly, hopefully before the topor goes down. Yeah, it's eating it up really quickly, and we're gonna have a level 120 dodo! Tame effectiveness might be a little bit down, but oh my god. That's like, that's the highest level dodo I've ever found. Guys. It might be the return of Frodo. I'm not gonna call it yet. There's a lot of possibilities, but it might very well be the return of Frodo, and this time he's gonna be coming in his most. I'm sounding like installing a lisp into how I talk. No, he's gonna be by far the highest level, and it might be the return of Frodo. I already know what I'm naming him Frodo just because of the fact that we've been blessed. Hashtag blessed, bless up, major key, with a level 120 dodo, just the first dodo we look at. That's a sign. Frodo's watching, and he wants us to succeed. Anyways, so today, I could go and show you guys the Carno and the Pteranodon. They leveled up like once or twice, nothing really super urgent, but I do want to show this new feature with the Dodos. I think you guys will really like them, and, I had a train of thought that was derailed and crashed horribly, and I don't think there were any survivors, but I'm gonna attempt to salvage it. And oh yeah, so, like I was saying with the salmon over there, if we find any good carnivores that we might want to tame, we can always hit those up, those salmon, for some fresh, friggity fresh, prime meat. But in the meantime, I kind of want to go explore over on the other side of the river. Might be a little bit risque here, but, you know, I mean, it's a couple risks never really killed any. Well, actually, they did. Risks are a large part of what kills. I take back that statement. I retract it. Don't quote me. That no, I retract it. Deleting all quotes of it on the internet. But I want to check out, cross over the river. Might be a little bit dangerous. Don't know where we might ford the river. But I want to check out those ruins. I didn't fully realize. Oh my god, I'm so sorry for yawning. It's like freaking noon when I'm recording this. I'm so sorry. Dude, I'm so excited about that dodo. I never saw that those ruins over there. I want to check those out, see what those are about. Maybe those will be where we end up ultimately building. And Frodo, welcome, my friend. Oh yeah, we also got to go tame name the Carno. But everybody, Frodo has returned. I'm sorry that you don't get to name this one, because this one has a very special place in our hearts. And look at that, 400% melee damage. Frodo is going to be a battler. Also, we ate exactly 30 Azul berries, kind of fitting. Level 171 Frodo. The server best, fear me. Anyways, you guys can probably see from the little pop-up here, you can now pick up dodos and just throw them. You can just throw dodos. It's actually hilarious. Like, look at this. Like, I just picking up a dodo. Speaking of picking up, I'm a monstrosity. I know, the dodo. Oh, dude, I never realized how big dodos are. Are dodos that big, really? Or am I that small? It might be a hybrid of the two. Anyways, if we like look up, can we like look at that? Get some distance on Frodo. Isn't that awesome? So what I saw, I was actually looking on Reddit right before I went on this. People were like already inventing like basketball type games with this. Oh, and nighttime's approaching. You can kind of tell. Well, because it's getting darker. What's that noise? Is that just the nighttime noise? And also the fireflies. I love the firefly effect. Anyways, yeah, we get to throw Frodo around. Look at that. Look at that. Hello, Frodo. Hello. Say hello to the people, Frodo. How are you doing? Oh, horrifying, I know. But hi, Frodo. So, Frodo. Welcome, my friend. I'm so happy. But yeah, I was actually looking around. People were like already playing, like they set up a basketball court and they were playing dodo basketball. And I kind of want to set that up. I feel like, I mean, I know we got to focus on being a powerhouse in PvP, but listen, everyone's got some time for leisure. And I fully intend on becoming the best dodo skitball player in the world. So suck it, nerds. Is there a fire there? Does someone have a base there already? Did someone claim those ruins? Aw, I was really looking forward to checking them out. We're still going to ford the river here. But I'm going to be really disappointed if someone already claimed it. Let's just make sure that there's no like piranhas that might destroy our faces. Like those salmon, however you want to pronounce it, should be cool. Yeah, salmon are cool. If we attack them, they won't be too cool. But I don't plan on attacking them. So just, you know, poop in their river real quick. Sign of respect, sign of tribute. And see what's going on here. By the looks of it, are those like those auto torches or something? I think someone may have claimed this. Because I don't want... Oh, hello, Campy. Hello. Hello. Don't aggro me. I don't... Oh, there's more of them around. Oh, they're going to start attacking me. Yeah, okay. Let's avoid the Campies. Not trying to draw that aggro. That's just going to be a nuisance to deal with. Has someone already claimed this? I mean, all I see is the torches. So maybe not yet. But if so, this could also be bad for us. Because that means someone's got a base very close to ours. And once PvP comes... Oh no, starvation. That's not good. Once PvP comes, this could definitely be a little bit of a... Not a little bit, this is going to be a quite large threat. And there's a Carno over there, don't want to mess with that. Where do these ruins begin? Okay, we're going to circle back around. I'm going to try to find my way into these ruins, and I'll let you guys know where that entrance exactly is. Ah, here we are. Found it. Oh, that thing is quite close. We didn't find it, though. Are these man-made structures? Welcome to Monkey Farm's castle. Course, Monkey Farm. Huh. I should have caught sight of these ruins quicker. This would have been an awesome place to build, but I guess Monkey Farm beat us to the catch. So, he hasn't really done anything here yet. He's literally claimed it. That's all he's done. Is that a Gallimimus up there, or is that a Parasaur? How does a Gallimimus get... What? I don't know. Anyways, okay. Kind of low-key, very salty about that. Not low-key. I'm salty about that, but I guess he did lay claim to it, and I didn't even know this existed till about 10 minutes ago. So, well, it does suck. There's nothing we can do. And I mean, it would, you know, it just gives us a reason to poop on his face, both literally and metaphorically, aka once PvP, you know, in those 50 days... We're probably gonna attack him. Oh, hello, Carno. You know what? I'm just gonna, can I slide down here? Start making our way back. So this isn't gonna be any good. Hold up. Actually, killing the Carno might be a fantastic... We can make one stone arrow. Really? I was gonna say, I don't know what level the Carno is, but that might be a perfect fight for us to get into, especially because, we're kind of in a position where I want XP. A lot of it. Any rocks we can hit? We'll get back to him. We still gotta name ours, but... What's that noise? I'm gonna try and craft up some stone arrows, get to a good position, and maybe start a little bit of a fight. Alright, I'll let you guys know how that goes. Alright, guys and gals, we're locked, we're loaded, and hopefully this Carno isn't locked nor loaded in the form of levels. If he's a really high level, this might go awful for us, but we got 43 arrows and a dream. Now that dream might be shattered, but it might also be lifted to the skies and elongated to greatness. That was... Oh no, oh no, oh no, we aggroed it, we aggroed it, we aggroed it. Oh no, rip, rip, rip. Oh, the water, with the water. Remember that you did a lot of damage in that first hit, though. What level is this guy? I don't want to know. Get to the water, get to the water, get to the water! Ah! It's our best friend. There we go. What level is that guy? Nope. Back in the water. Hello, Mr. Carno. Hello. Oh, he's still chasing us. It's a 125. What the hell? Okay. No, as long as, like, literally, if we peek out of the water, he is not happy at all about our decision making. Oh no, he's still not happy at all. Okay, you know what? Well, we might die. No. Okay, he's going away. Oh, piranhas, really, piranhas? Not now. I'm being killed by everything. Really. Okay, piranhas. Peace treaty. Peace. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna die. Seems that the river has been populated by piranhas, and that Carno, we gotta wait for him to go away. Hopefully he does. He obviously did not appreciate, he took exception to the fact that we were gonna be hunting him. Didn't seem to be too big of a fan of it. Okay. Multiple predicaments. A, we gotta cross the river in a safe place, no piranhas. B, we gotta get around the Carno. See, we gotta kill that thing to get some mad XP. We could also just continue crafting. Why do I have no health right now? Oh, that's just a graphical glitch. Okay. I don't know if you guys saw that, but it literally showed me having this lower right-hand corner, zero health. Let you guys know how this recovery effort goes. Hopefully well. Alright, this is our chance. I've lured the piranhas away. Hopefully we do not aggro him here. We gotta get our stamina back. We're gonna make a sprint for this bag. And hopefully survive. We don't have to poop yet. We might have to after this suicide adventure. Okay, no, he's pretty far away. Okay. Get our stuff. Run. Hopefully get to the ruins. Maybe attack him from there. Okay. Access. Take all. Get the hell out of Dodge. Assess the situation. We're Carno hunting, boys. And this is no Carno to be joked with. However, if we kill a 125 Carno, man... Oh, okay, he's aggroed something else first. He's hungry, man. He's a horned devil, that's what he is. Just gotta make our way to the entrance. I do know where the entrance is, but... So does the Carno, since he seems to be guarding it. He's gonna have to wander away a little bit. Actually, he seems to have wandered away. Gotta make our way up there. And hopefully have a little safe haven. Alright, we gotta begin our assault. Go. Hope he doesn't follow us into this. And if he does, we can always jump off a cliff. Now, no way he can go through all of this, right? This is like a maze to him. Where'd he go? Did he not follow the aggro? Or is he lurking outside? Honestly, I don't want to know. Kinda scared to find out. Mr. Carno. Hello, friend. This is frightening. He's nowhere where I'd expect him to be. Maybe he's below this area? It's the only thing I can possibly think of. Yeah. Oh, of course we're dehydrated. Really? Well, hopefully we don't die of dehydration, but we got a lot of arrows. And a dream. of a Carno that we want to see dead. Okay, he's a feisty one. He's going to keep moving. This is going to be really hard to hit him. Okay, this side of the river sucks. That's what I have deduced. Okay, stop moving, Carno. Just accept... this is going to be... Okay, no, I'm done. That is way too annoying to attack. Screw you, Carno. Sick of your crap. I'm getting dehydrated. We're gonna walk away from that situation. We've explored the other side of the river. That Carno is way too high level for us to deal with. It's whatever. If you can't tell, today's a very salty day. Today just has not been a good day for me in general, but at the very least, I do want to tame up a Listosaurus. That was another thing on my checklist that I didn't really explicitly mention, but it would be nice to have their just kind of bonus XP traits lying around and supplying our dinos and us with that bonus XP for when we're like crafting, when we are just kind of idling, all that stuff. It does supply bonus XP, which is super helpful. So if we could just get our way into the river, please give me some stamina, game. Health wise, still pretty high. Is it regenerating faster than we're losing it? No, we're still definitely losing it. Oh no. Oh god, I thought he was still aggroed on us. I was actually just gonna be like, okay, I give up, game. You got the best of me. If that Carno's still following me, it's a death wish from you. Please give me some water. I am so thirsty. Speaking of that, dinosaurs. Apparently terror birds are found in this area. One time when I logged on just to make sure my dinos were fed over the past couple days. Dude, there's a terror bird attacking me. I was scared. My Carno was able to save me. I was like, opened the gates and escaped into there. And the Carno did work, but terror birds are kind of scary, man. I wasn't expecting that. Yo, are those piranhas still around here? I don't know. Oh, we are way too tired. Okay. I'll let you guys know when we're back at base. All right, we return. I'm not back on the other base because I found something that I kind of want to keep. Now, hopefully no dillos come from God knows where to attack me for doing probably the greatest war crime in dillo history, because that's what they treat it as. All right, if you pick up the egg of a species, you will be hunted like nothing else. And oh my god, speaking of being hunted, stay away, demon! Stay away! Oh no. No. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. I don't want to die. I don't want to die. Please. Please. I'm done with it. Oh no. Oh no. Oh. The good news, we crossed most of that river before we died, and were able to respawn. The bad news, we died, which seems to happen a lot today. Well, I think I know where I died since they're- Oh, don't tell me they're just gonna- Yo, swim, go, leave. Go away, piranhas. No. Not cool. Shoo. Shoot, oh my god, that Carno is doing work on the other side of the river. I'm happy it's on the other side and not on this one, okay. Oh, there we go. Okay, take all. There we go. Hopefully I can get to shore before they murder me. Yes. That was some MLG tactics. Screw you guys. I'm killing these guys. I'm getting the XP for this. High level piranhas, that's also high XP for me. Get back here. I'm going to kill you. Please, I just want to kill you. Oh no, not the water, that's their habitat. Oh, really? I can't even craft another spear? Why can I not craft another spear? Okay, you know what, I got arrows. I will diversify my killing methods. I'm a smart man. Please, piranha. Yes! It died. We got like no XP for that, not even worth it. All right, well, where are these Listosauruses? I'm gonna go gather up some meho berries. And what level are you, buddy? Level 4, sure. I don't think the level that we tame one at really matters, because they kind of, I don't think they really will fight in the first place. And really, the only thing I'm interested in is that XP boost. So we're just gonna grab some meho berries, tame up one of these. And that and the Dodo will be today's tame. I actually do need a tame for this guy, and speaking of naming our tames, the Carno will be named here shortly. I'll actually go do that now, since I feel like I should have done that by now.
Hello, Mr. Carno. Are you ready to have a name?
I think so. Oh. Yeah, we're also going to continue doing some base building work, probably off camera, just make sure that we can... Well, I don't know. Maybe make these walls like one higher on that side and actually begin working on the base over here. And then once we're back on camera, I do want to document. I think that's the right word to use here. Our journey towards getting a raptor, if we could find one. But a big thing would be the refining forge and the schmitty, along with some tools. That'd be really good. I don't know where to find metal. If you guys know where to find metal at all, let me know in the comments, along with a potential name for a Listosaurus, but I'll kind of mention that more explicitly once that happens. Anyways, awesome comment. Nice. I actually chuckled when I read this comment. So, in episode 2, I believe it was, someone said you should name it Forest since, well, since, as you guys know, run, Forest, run. And this Carno was just constantly fleeing from me. And kind of, it's got the color of a forest. So now whenever our Carno's fighting, we can be like, I don't know, we can make sick references to Forrest Gump. Run, Forrest, run. So, yeah, dank maymays will commence. How's the Mahoberries looking? We got two of them. Wow. Wow. I would have thought we had a little bit more than two, but okay, there we go. Oh, Jesus. We just found the Mahoberry bush. My God. Sweet Lord of Jesus. Oh, my God. We're finding all the Mahoberries now. This is what I like. Oh, my God. Another four. What are we up to? 18, 20. For a level four, that should be plenty. And I mean, it's not like this is going to be really too challenging of a tame. Hello, Mr. Listosaur. But it is going to help us out. Immensely, probably not, but definitely a good amount of help. Taming effectiveness, yeah, it's gonna take what, maybe five more Maho berries. So I'll let you guys know once we are done taming up this guy. But in the, oh my God, I just realized that is a giant salmon. My God, hold up, can we appreciate that? Whew. I just want to go underwater to look at it, but that salmon is huge. It's huge! Oh my God, hello Pteranodon. Ooh, 95. I wouldn't mind taming up a higher level Pteranodon. I mean, at the end of the day, we still have a Pteranodon, so it doesn't really matter. Either way, it's good. And yeah, whatever. I'll just let you guys know when the Listosaurus tamed up. But to prepare for that, when he is tamed up, barring catastrophes such as asteroids raining from the sky, Carnotaurs learning to swim, and or any other variety of death-inducing methods, you guys should in the comment section down below if you got any cool names to name this guy. I mean, Doge is probably my go-to name for him as my personal one, but you guys might be able to come up with something better. And if you do, if you have any idea at all, comment section down below. Just leave a comment. It takes like, what, probably 5-10 seconds max to just type out a name. And if you're feeling extra dedicated, you could scroll through the comments a little bit and hit that thumbs up button on any comments that you guys do like. This guy's a pooping machine. It's like he's laying a M&M trail of poop. And it's like that one Family Guy episode where it's like, ooh, piece of candy. Ooh, piece of candy. Except, ooh, piece of poop. Ooh, piece of poop. Hey, it's the Listosaur. Except I'm eventually actually fall into like a trap or something. But we're just going to tame up that guy. And yeah, comment section down below. I mean, if you're feeling extra generous, scroll through a little bit and like any comments that you guys do like. That any names you might like. But also feel free to leave that comment. And next episode, we'll have a name for him. Also, next episode, we'll have a name for the Pteranodon. I would have a name for the Pteranodon now. But the first episode's only been up for a couple hours, and I want to give everyone a chance to put their name in. So, Pteranodon naming going on in the last episode. But I'll let you guys know when this guy's all finished up, and we'll see where the episode goes from there. Alright guys, so as this poop trail expands, and I contribute it to it a little bit. Oh my God, look at how much poop that is. And I attempt on my own some to contribute to his poop trail. It is time to cap off the tame. Welcome, Listrosaurus. How do you do? Name, I don't have one currently, but we will eventually. Hello, Listro. Oh, I can pet it. Look at that. Oh, give it a little pet. Oh, it's adorable. And once you give it a pet, the XP bar, or you do get bonus XP for the stuff you do. Just make sure this guy's following us. We are going to escort him back to base, and I think that at this point it's been like a 20-minute something episode. I'm really sorry. I was hoping to get a lot more done, but disaster happened in every sense of the word on the other side of the river. The ruins were taken. They're not the biggest ruins, but still, they're pretty cool, I gotta admit. The ruins were taken. We tried hunting a Carno for XP. Turns out the Carno was hunting us for XP. And piranhas went rabid, totaling a, what, like three deaths? Something like that? No, I think it was two deaths. Yeah, once the piranhas once to piranhas and the carno, so unless like a tree wants to fall over real quick on me to like even it up to like a nice three or odd it up to like a nice three, dude, that lightning in the sky is awesome. I think we're gonna be safe for the rest of today. Lickety scuttle. Oh my god, I'm just like playing sound clips of like Zoidberg in my head, like just like, I don't know, looking at him scuttle is adorable. And if we can bring him over here, at least when he's close to these guys, he should be able to help him out XP-wise. Maybe we have to pet him around all the other dinos? Is that how it works? I don't know. Can I pet you again there, buddy? Can I do that? No, we'll figure that out. Targeting range. Chance targeting range. Oh, change. I read that as chance for some reason. I've been listening to too much of Chance the Rapper lately. My bad, but our base coming along nicely. The den for all our dinos is looking pretty safe. We're going to build this into an actual base and just make sure things are looking safe and secure. Do some of that work probably next episode. And I do have a very cool surprise in store for you guys. Maybe next episode. I think you guys will like it. And it'll definitely spice things up a little bit. So prepare for deliciousness. That's what I'll tease it with. Prepare for deliciousness. So take that as you will, but next episode you will hopefully see what that's about, and we'll take things from there. Definitely do want to do some map exploration, potentially get an actual mount that doesn't suck like a raptor, probably build up a lot of trank arrows. I think that's pretty high up on the list, so we could actually get a solid tame. I mean, we got the Carno, which is an amazing tame, well, not amazing, but it's pretty damn good. Problem is, we're level 27, so we're about halfway to actually riding the guy. And I'm gonna throw my narco berries. Actually, I'm gonna grab these things and craft up some. Oh, there we go. The XP boost applied to Frodo. That took a while for some reason, but it did apply. I don't know if it's gonna apply to Forest, but hopefully it does. I'm going to put that spoiled meat to good use, and also I'm gonna throw the egg on him. We can make some kibble out of that one day. Don't know what kibble... Oh, that thing's not going to spoil for forever. Don't know what kibble that ends up becoming, but it might be something good. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching the video. Like I said, just wrapping it up here, crafting up a few things, but that's about going to do it. I'm just going to make sure I got some food for my dinos, too. Probably do like a little bit of minor hunting, but I don't think you guys really want to see that too much. So let's get the narcos, get 7 of those narcotics. I think I have them stored somewhere, right? Yeah, currently we got 27, so we can make a good amount of trank arrows if need be. But other than that, that is going to go ahead and do it for me. Thank you guys so much for watching the video as always, and hopefully I'll see you next one.